Today, we're gonna run through everything that you need to know about Protune on the Hero 3 Plus Black Edition. So Protune, what is it and why do we use it? First of all, when you turn on Protune, it ups the quality of your video. It turns up what's known as the bitrate, which takes up more space on your SD card, but it also makes your footage that much more crisp and clear when you're doing stuff in high motion. I've always got Protune turned on my cameras because I always want the highest quality. Also, when you turn on Protune, it unlocks a whole new feature set of capture settings that you can really use to customize and make the most out of your GoPro. Once you turn on Protune, the first thing that we'll come to is the white balance. This will adjust the color temperature of your video from a cool blue to a warm yellow. By default, it's set to auto, which does a really good job of most situations. I pretty much always keep my cameras in auto. White balance is used a lot if you want to really control the color temperature of your video. So if you're shooting indoors or in a studio, experiment with going from 3000 Kelvin all the way up to 6500 Kelvin, and even camera raw. Now, camera raw is just a setting that doesn't actually apply any white balance correction, so it's pretty much native out of the camera. So next on the list is ISO, and ISO really affects the amount of light that you'll have in your footage in lower light situations. So at dusk or at night or indoors, this is where the setting is really going to come into effect. If you've got your camera in a lower ISO settings, it means your footage will be darker at lower light, but it'll also be cleaner and less noisy or grainy. When you want to have more light indoors or at low light, bump up the ISO to 6400 and you'll see a brighter video file, you'll see more information, but it'll be at the expense of some noise and grain in the video. I always keep mine at ISO 400 just because I like to control the light, and if I need more light, I'll add more light, but I really like to have clean, dark video footage. Moving on down the list, we come to the sharpness settings in the camera. By default, the camera adds digital sharpness so it has the appearance of being sharper. If you'd like less sharpening, you can move it to medium, or even minimal sharpening, move it to low. The video footage will appear softer, but you can add the sharpening back in post, and that's what I like to do. It really gives you the ability to really control your footage. So moving on down the list, we've got the color profile. By default, it's set to GoPro color, which is a vibrant, saturated look that you're used to seeing from the GoPro. If you're experienced at color correction, or if you're trying to match your video footage to other cameras, use the flat color profile setting. I like to keep mine in GoPro color pretty much all the time because it gets a good vibrant color, and I don't really want to do that much in post. So last on the list is the exposure compensation value. And this basically tells the camera to auto-adjust either above or below the normal auto exposure. So if you always want your footage to be slightly overexposed, bump it up above zero, and if you always want it to be underexposed, bump it down below zero. All right, this has been your Sunday afternoon Protune bike ride with the GoPro Media team. We're almost to the lake, gonna go enjoy the sunshine. Hopefully you guys have a better understanding of what Protune is, how it affects your video footage, and how you can utilize it to maximize your GoPro. Thanks for tuning in, and be sure to check out more tutorials coming soon.